Problem students, we are discussing friction. The last classes started about static and dynamic friction, loss of friction, equilibrium of your body on a rough horizontal plane, inclined plane, and inclined plane just subjected to a force acting along the inclined plane. Up to this, we discussed last classes. We are going to discuss now the again. Rough horizontal plane problems and inclined plane subject to force acting along the inclined plane. Okay. This is a horizontal plane. Any body is resting. You see this one. The body is resting in the your applied force P in the right side. As per concept of friction, the friction is always acting opposite to the motion of the body, moving of the body. Okay. Applying force on the right side. Therefore, friction is left side as a contact surface. That is limiting friction or maximum friction. Then weight is acting perpendicular downward. And block, no, every action equal to opposite action. No? The reaction is upward R. So we have F equal to mu into R or mu into N. Then you consider this force system is here. Coplanar concurrent force systems. That means all forces passing through a single point. Okay. Even though friction is at the contact surface, but the net effect of the friction must go to the middle. So all forces meeting at a middle point. That assumption we consider the equilibrium equations. Summation of H0, summation of V0. That is separating the coefficient of friction, no? Mu equal to F divided by R. F means friction, R means reaction. The pi equal to angle of friction. Pi equal to angle of friction. Therefore, tan pi equal to, see that this one, tan pi equal to, this is the bottom diagram. Tan pi equal to opposite divided by adjacent side. Therefore, F divided by R. Tan pi equal to F limit divided by N. That is angle of friction. Tan pi equal to F divided by R. Therefore, what is F divided by R? Mu. So we can write the mu equal to F divided by R, force divided by reaction, or tan pi. Okay. Then this is a horizontal plane. We started about these problems. This question, they did not given any diagram. So the only statement given, see the statement, a body of weight 300 Newton is lying on a rough horizontal plane. Just imagine a body is resting on a horizontal plane. The coefficient of friction is 0.3. Mu equal to 0.3. Find the magnitude of the force which can move the body. They asked one force, applied force, which can move the body while acting at an angle of 25 degree. So the applied force with respect to horizontal 25 degree they mentioned. So I have taken applied force P. Okay. Therefore, they asked what is the P. So very simple, no? What is the free next? Free body diagram. See here. Weight is acting vertical downward. Then normal reaction. The applied force, the right side, no? Applied force, right side. Therefore, the friction is left side. Fp equal to mu r. So the P incline, no? Two component. P cos 25. P sin 25. P cos 25. P sin 25. So after drawing the free body diagram, you apply the equation, summation of H0, summation of V0. So we know, you know this procedure, horizontal forces, right side positive, left side minus. Then putting equal to 0, then after simplification, we get this equation. See, whenever you say here F, then no friction, no, that you have to write mu into R. So mu will be given. Okay, so form the equation 1 like that. Then summation of V equal to 0, resolve the vertical forces. Vertical upward plus vertical downward minus. Then we get the equation, then apply in the equation 2 in equation 1, like that you can get the applied force. In this question, any doubt? Any doubt? Kavi? Any question? Kavi? Sindhuja?
No, sir.
Okay. So we discussed a very simple question, no? Then next question. In this question, here also they did not given the diagram, they given only statement. What statement given? A body resting on a rough horizontal plane. One body is there. You see, if you say any body, it has weight. Students, if you say any body, it has a weight. So they did not give weight. So I marked a W. Horizontal plane. Put one body resting on a horizontal. Required to pull 180 Newton. Required to pull 180 Newton. Incline at 30 degree. So they are pulling. You know, pulling means, you know, that the front side, you know, that is 180 incline degree, 30 degree. 30 degree to the plane, just to move. Just to move, they applied the first pulling 180 Newton. This is the first condition. See, the question is the first condition. We have to decide if it's the first condition. Next, see that it was found that a push of 220 Newton. It was found that a push of 220 Newton incline at 30 degree. So push means, you know, we apply in the whenever the bus is break down on the road, it's sometime we are applying pushing the front passenger, no, from the back side. So the pushing, we can push like this only. So the angle also is 30 degree again. Incline at 30 degree. Push. This is the pulling, this is pushing. So ask to determine the weight of the body and coefficient. So same body, they are pulling 180 Newton, 30 degree. For movement, for the movement of the body. Are they same body? They are pushing 220 Newton, angle 30 degree. Then what is the W and mu? Okay. So here you consider case by case. Case one, this is case one. What case one? Pulling. So resolve all forces. So the weight, how we have weight, no? Anybody have weight? So vertical acting downward. Then this case one, no? That's why I am taking the N1. Or R1. See, take R1. R1 means reaction. Students, here R1 means normal reaction. Then the body is moving right side, no? So the body is inclined, no? And the applied force, 180. 180 is inclined, no? Therefore, 180 cos 30, 180 sin 30. The friction force left side. Then apply equilibrium equations. So here we do not know that W, mu and R. Okay? So I am forming the equation like this. Let me explain. So you have to recollect it. So form the equation. Equation 1. After solving summation H, summation V. Then form equation A. See here the final equation A. Okay. Mu into something. Then see, now come to case 2. Now pushing, no. That pushing force goes to fourth quadrant. See there. You are pushing the back side, but the arrow mark goes to which direction? Fourth quadrant, no. So what is fourth quadrant, students? X plus Y minus. So 220 cos 30, 220 downward. 220 cos 30 plus X direction. 220 sin 30 vertical Y direction. See here. So body is motion right side. Body moving right side. Therefore friction is opposite. See here, we have to focus friction. Because friction is which side? Y left side friction. Because body moving right side. We know weight is acting vertical downward. Vertical acting downward, normal reaction. So this case 2, again use the same equilibrium equation. Okay. Then here case 2, no, that's why I mentioned the N2R2, case 2, no. Body is the same body, so weight also common only. So I did not make a W1, W2, same body. Okay, only the applied force is different, no, the 200 angle, therefore friction is different here. Okay, same surface, the mu also same, so W and mu. Only the reaction and the that's the reaction only changes. So the case null F2. So after resolving this one, we will get the equation B. equation 3, 4 you will get. Then after applying the equation 4 in equation 3, you will get this equation. Then you already have equation 1, no, equation A, no, case 1. Now equation B. Then you have to divide A divided by B. A divided by B. So the mu means here upper is mu, lower is mu, mu cancelled. So after cross multiplication, you will get W. Then apply this value in any one equation, equation A or equation B. So you will get the answer, mu equal to 0.1. Kavi, any question? Kavi?
So Kavi's network is weak, it seems, sir.
Okay. Vikinesh, are you understand this problem?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Already you discussed, so this is very important, no? So recollect it. Okay. Now this is also very interesting, no? Very interesting. See here. One block, in the question, the given diagram. See, whenever the diagram given, it's easy to, if diagram not given, you can draw the diagram, but in diagram given, so one work is over, already get diagram given, no? So here, two block, A and B, weights, 1 kN, 2 kN. Respectively, R in equilibrium position, as shown in figure. The coefficient of friction between the two blocks. So, never say friction, wherever contact, see here the block A and block B. Therefore, there is a contact, no? There is contact. Similarly, the block B contact with the surface. So, at the two contact places, so two frictions. So, that's why they mentioned the coefficient of friction between block two blocks, as well as the block B and the floor. So, in between block and floor, the mu will be 0.3. And also in between block A and B, mu 3, find the force P to move the block B. So here, two block given. What is this, you know, the connected, no? I told you connected, the third degree, you know, connected. Students, whenever connected, there is a tension. So you remember always, whenever connected, tension. So for this type of problem, you consider first block A. Because block A is upper side, no? So consider block A. So block A, just focus only block A. Don't see the block B now. So the block A connected at the incline, sorry, incline tension, no? Therefore tension, see here. So T cos theta, T sin theta. Then the block one, weight, no? So the A, I'm taking one. Students, the block A, I take as one. That's the weight W1. Then the W1 opposite reaction, no? R1. So the friction force, F1 left side. Why friction for F1 left side? Because tension is right side, no? Tension is the applied force when considered. See, we don't consider a total figure now, total block. You consider each block now. So if we consider a block here, it's a connected tension here. That's why friction is also left side. That's why F1 equal to mu1 R1. So the one means block A. I have changed the name, block A1. Then apply the equilibrium equations, the resolve it, the finally you will get, after application, you know, summation fx zero, that is you will get equation one, the summation of v, then you get R1 reaction, then apply in equation two in equation one, you will get the final equation, then you will get R1 finally. So we know F1 equal to mu1 R1, mu1 is given already, mu1 means the friction between two blocks, mu equal to given. So you will get F1. But our aim is only P value. They ask only P, no? Applied force P. Now come to block B. Now come to block B. So block B, you see the force, applied force. P is applied force. You move in which direction? Left direction. So the block B is conducted two places, no? The bottom floor, upper another block. Students, remember how when friction is developing, when two body surface, contact surfaces. So your block B conducted bottom floor, the upper another block. Therefore, two friction, F1, F2. Why F1, F2 left side? Because applied force left side. Why F1, F2 right side? Plus B is left side. No, that's why the F1, F2 right side. Now come to weight. So we know the body, 2 means the block, you know. The block B is attack 2. So the weight is acting vertical downward. Then the normal reaction acting upward R2. Similarly, the block touching upper side also. That reaction will come, no? R1. Students, why the R1 is downward? Because this block, the block B, touching, see here, at two reaction on the block B touching upper side also. So reaction always what here B, see the B is action, action at two place, no? A block acts, the B is acted at A, therefore reaction downward. Similar B is touching in the bottom floor, therefore R2 upward. Students, remember, okay, why R1 is downward? Because B is touching on A, therefore that reaction comes down R1. Similarly, the B is touching floor, okay, the R2 is upward. So you know procedure, again, we know already calculated, no, R1 already calculated from previous in R1 calculated, F1 also calculated. So even though F2 equal to mu to R2, after using this equation, you will get everything from the equation, apply. Okay. Now, next important, we discussed about the inclined plane. Students, this is an incline. I will explain by through paint. I will sharing paint how I draw this diagram, how the alpha coming here. I'll explain through paint. Okay. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. See here, the previous problem, three problem on the horizontal plane. So the weight is acting downward. Now the block is inclined plane. Now what do you have seen? Now what you are seeing? Only block, only whiteboard, no?
White, yes.
Yeah, okay. Just imagine here. See, now the surface not horizontal, is inclined surface now. Okay. Inclined surface. See here, inclined. Okay. The inclined surface angle alpha. For example, take 30 degree. Just imagine, student, 30 degree. Now the one block is resting on the Vignesh, are you watching?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now the block weight is resting on inclined surface. So previous problem we discussed, all the weight is vertical downward, but here inclined surface, no. So what I am doing, just imagine here also weight is acting vertical downward. Students, here also vertical with respect to horizontal surface. With respect to horizontal surface, the weight is acting perpendicularly downward. Students, okay. Perpendicularly downward. Okay. Weight is acting perpendicularly downward. Now see the 90 degree. Perpendicular downward with respect to horizontal, perpendicular 90 degree. So here also, this side also 90 degree. So what I am doing, students, we are see in the first unit and second unit we discuss. I told you, know, with respect to the x-axis quadrant only, we can resolve the problems. Okay. So you see, just imagine, student, the block is moving upward. Student, just imagine the block is moving upward. What about friction? Friction is downward. Okay. So I am drawing in the quadrant x-axis, y-axis with respect to the inclined plane, parallel to inclined. See here. Y-axis with respect to block, y-axis, perpendicular, y-axis, okay, then x-axis. So this is x-axis, y-axis. But our weight is here. So we are solving problem, no? So with respect to x-axis or y-axis, we have to consider the weight now. Okay. Therefore, see here, this 90, here 30. What about this angle? Vicky, what about this angle here? Students, this angle. Vignesh, what about this angle? Sindhuja, what is angle?
So 60.
Ah, okay. 60 degree. Okay. 60 degree. Now tell me, students, now tell me, see here, what about this angle? Anyone tell me, what about this angle? Now, anyone tell me, this angle. Students, anyone? This angle. Tell me. Vignesh, what is angle? This angle. Sindhuja? You see the right angle triangle like this. You have to see the right angle triangle. Something you have to tell me. You tell you what is your answer, right or wrong? I will decide. What is the angle?
45.
Sir.
I know.
It may be
wrong only, sir. I don't
know. How do you say 45? If you are asking me, how do you say 45? Tell me.
No, sir. The triangle is 90
degrees. Already we have drawn some angle here. You use your knowledge, yeah. Is your mathematical skill
whole triangle? Sir, 30, 90. Sir, it is 60 only, sir.
Tell me.
60 tell only.
Me. How? Exactly.
Sir, because that is 30 and that black and green coincide means it's coming as 90 degrees, sir.
Yes. So this angle 90 degrees. Yes, this angle 90, no. This angle 90, yes. Wait. So we know this angle 90. So already here, see the, just imagine. This is A point at B point. B is C. Yes, so B is 90, at A, no, A 30. What about this angle? Now 60. Okay. So this angle, 60. Now tell me angle, I am going to mark the angle. Vignesh or Kavi or Ajaj, you can tell me. Now tell me what is the angle here. This angle. Anyone? What is the angle?
30.
Yeah, 30. How 30? You see here already 90. 90, 60, so balance 30. Okay, that's why we resolved a body. Already I shown the diagram here. Listen, so I try again. Thank you. x y axis. So this weight in the see this weight acting, we know very downward. Ajaz, are you following? Ajaz, Mohammed. So this weight, so angle now we know 30 degree. This angle 30 degree. 80. So it's which quadrant? This W. W which quadrant? Third quadrant, no? Theta which axis? Y axis. Okay. So W lying in third quadrant, theta y axis. Therefore, we have to resolve in xy direction. Third quadrant means x minus y plus, no? Therefore, the weight. So here. W cos 80. Yes, W cos 80. Cos 80. This W 80. Why sine? Because theta is only y axis. That come to cast this sign. Understand? That's why any block in is inclined, the weight is converted into two component, W cos 30, W sin 30. Sinuja, are you understand? Class rep?
Yes, sir.
Now is you okay?
Yes.
Any question? Vignesh?
Yes, sir.
Are you followed this diagram?
Yes, sir.
That's why any block is inclined. This is the way we convert. Whatever angle, see here, 30 degree given, no? So you have to blindly take it, W cos. Suppose 60 degree given here, yeah, at A, 60 degree given. It directly W cos 60, W sin 60. So here I explained how the weight is converted into W cos 30, W sin 30 with respect to xy axis. Why I am writing with respect? Because we want to solve the problem, no? That's why the block I consider with respect to the block, I draw the x axis, y axis. Okay? That's why see here. The block is here. The alpha I directly mentioned. How the alpha is came, I explained just now. So suppose incline, this is the way. W cos alpha, W is the sin alpha. Then we know reactions. Reaction is upward because contact point. So you mind it, any block is in incline surfaces, this is the way convert. The whatever angle given, whether it's angle given, directly write it. W cos alpha, W sin alpha. Then we applied, see here, the block is the statement, they mentioned the body is sliding downwards. See the highlight I highlighted, the point of sliding downwards. Even though we applied force upward, but the body is moving downward. Therefore, friction is again for this problem, friction is upward. Okay. So don't see here P1, see the statement. You just imagine, suppose you are moving on the mount. The mount is sometimes always inclined, no? suppose one fellow is slipping down from upper side, you are bottom side, you are holding your hand on the back of the that man. Even though you are applying some small force, he is trying to moving downward only, no? That same thing here. For this condition, the statement, the applied force is also P1, but if the body is sliding downwards, the men's end, understand? That's why the friction is I put down upward, F, okay? So we know the weight is always, you know, 2 common, no? W cos alpha, W sin alpha, okay? Then we want what is P1. So you can use the equilibrium equation, yeah? You can equilibrium directly solve the problem. Here I derived the final equation. Here I derived. No need to derive. Directly apply the equation of supply value given, alpha 25 given, W 30 some value given, no? Here is use this equation and solve like previous problem, no? Here I for I derived the formulas. Okay, the final formula. Okay. So you can memory it or otherwise leave it, then apply free body diagram, solve it. As per previous, now we discussed three problem, no? Now something here, see the statement. Here also the diagram given, the applied force acted, but the sliding upwards, the body is moving sliding upwards. We are applying the applying force, the body is sliding upwards, students sliding upward, body is moving upward. The friction is downward. Okay, F is, you know, downward, no, that's why. And the other thing same, W cos alpha, W sin alpha. Here you see you can equilibrium equation. I derived the formula. No need to derive formula. You can apply value. Supply value is given, you can apply. So here we finally find it. Okay. Then we solve the problems. Your body weight, 500 Newton is lying on a rough plane inclined at the angle of 25 degree. See, rough plane, inclined, rough plane. So 25 degree, rough plane. 500 Newton. Then it is supported by effort P parallel to the planes. It's not parallel, no, the incline parallel, P is parallel to incline, okay? Then determine the minimum and the maximum value of P for the which equilibrium can exist if the angle of friction is 25 degrees. Students, angle of friction means tan pi. That is pi value, pi equal 20 degree. Whenever angle of friction can take us here, pi. Okay? So pi equal to, we have taken pi, the angle of friction 20. So already we have formula, no? They will, that's a direct formula. Two conditions. First condition, the block is moving downward, P is applying upward, the friction also the upward. So the direct formula is directly applied. Then this one, here the body is sliding downwards, so blade sliding upwards, the friction force action downward. So we have already derived, no, the formulas. Okay, derived, no, the direct issues. Sometimes no need to use this formula. You can apply the free body diagram, you draw the free body diagram like this, draw the free body diagram, everything. Here alpha 25, 20 given, that applied value also given, everything given, no. Applied was not given, weight is equal to 500, no. There are 500 cos, you can resolve it and apply equilibrium equation, find it. Okay. We solved the problem already. Then this one. Here is also the question is given, but the diagram not given. Students, an effort 200 Newton is required just to move a certain body up inclined plane of angle 15 degree. The angle of inclined plane alpha is 15 degree. When effort 200 Newton, effort means applied force. Students, effort means applied force 200 Newton required to move a certain body. One body is there acting parallel. Acting parallel. See this one 200 Newton acting parallel means inclined surface alpha 15 degree. First condition move your body up. See here, move body up. So the body is moving upward. Now the same body, understand, second condition. If the angle of inclination of plane is 20 degree. So alpha the inclination 20 degree. Now apply force 230. They apply force 230 and the body move up to the plane. Find the what is weight and friction. See the diagram. That is same force applying upper side 230 parallel to inclined plane, angle 20 degree. What is the weight and ask what is a weight and mu. Okay, find the weight of the body question. So now case one, draw the free body diagram. No, simple free body diagram. They mentioned, see, the questions are mentioned, the body is moving upward. They mentioned that's why friction is downward. Both the case friction is downward. Okay, then weight is, you know, we already told you W cos alpha, W sin alpha. Here two angles, alpha one, alpha two, I taken. But the same body, so same body only. That's why W data taken W and W2. If it say W and W2, say two body, no, two different bodies. So here W is common, mu also common. But this type of problems, W is common, mu also common. Only the applied force changes. Okay. So W cos alpha and W sin alpha. Then you can resolve it to each one. Case one. From the equation. Already the similar problem solved like in the horizontal plane also. From the equation A. Now case two. Resolve it. Now you got the equation B. Then divide B divided by A. Okay. After simplification, you will get the answer. Mu equal to 0.25. Students, remember, mu equal to always less than 1 or sometimes always less than 0.5. Always less than 1. Maximum of time, the mu always less than 0.5. Suppose your mu value is something above 1 or 1 near 1, this is not a correct one. That you have done some mistake. Students, always remember, mu must be less than 1 or less than 0.5. Okay. So our mu is 0.25. So it's a correct value. Then apply an equation A, you will get a W. Wait. I understand, students. Here also the inclined surface plane solved. Okay. Any question? Any question? Vignesh?
No, sir.
What you are seeing now? Is it visible now? I change the screen. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
What you are seeing?
Equilibrium of a body on a rough inclined plane subjected to a force acting horizontally.
The same problem only. Now the force here, the P is acting horizontal. Even the block is inclined. I told you, know, we have to convert with respect to the x-axis, y-axis, we have to convert. Already we converted W cos alpha, W sin alpha. I explained how the alpha is coming. Similarly, you see that the P1 is horizontal. I explained through paint. I'll share in the paint, I will explain you, okay? So the body is inclined with angle, for example, 20 degree. Example, for imagine 20 degree. 20 degree. Okay. So we know W cos alpha, W sin alpha, already explained. Now in this our question, in this our inclined surface, the force is acting horizontal. The force is acting horizontal, like this. Okay, horizontal. Okay, so we know x-axis, y-axis like this. This is the y-axis. Then this is the x-axis. See, the force is horizontal, understand, but with respect to x, y axis is inclined, no? What is the inclination angle, that angle? Can anyone tell me what is this angle? I marked here. What is this angle? Anyone tell me? What is this angle with respect to x axis? Anyone? Anyone? Vicky?
Yes, sir.
What is the angle? See, we have this diagram. Tell me. You can plainly tell me some angle. You see the diagram.
45, sir.
I have given clue also. See the diagram, tell the angle. Kavi? Class ref, what is angle? See the diagram, tell the angle. See the diagram, tell the angle. See the diagram. The kulu also I given.
20, sir.
Yeah, 20.
The diagram 20 only.
Yeah? How is it 20? That is the question. That is our, that's why.
Sir, actually, I thought 45, sir, because.
No. Just imagine you have studied here. Yeah, already you studied. See here. Any inclined surface. Just imagine. Any inclined surfaces. I draw one line here. This line, horizontal, no? Here also I draw the line. Just imagine, here also this line. Okay? Here, this is the angle. Now this angle, just imagine 20 degree. Just imagine 20 degree. Now what is this angle?
Sir, that also 20 only, sir. Because corresponding angles are equal, something.
You just see the, our diagram, the same concept we applied. Same concept only applied. Can you tell me?
Sir, 20 only, sir.
20 only, na? How?
The corresponding angles are equal. If the two parallel lines are drawn, means they will say in that way.
See here. This is a horizontal, no? The students, this inclined surface also horizontal. See, this is horizontal. Understand? Just imagine. This is also in horizontal. So this is also horizontal. Yes? So here also 20. So they say the inclined surface also parallel, no? Students, the inclined surface also parallel. Okay. Yes. So yeah, so here also 20. Automatically here also 20. See here. That means here. I should mark it here. Here. So the same line only. So 20 only. Now you got? All of you understand? Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, then now you can say the P is inclined. Which quarter in this one? Is the fourth quarter, no? So fourth quarter means X plus Y minus. So P cos alpha, the right that right side. Because theta is X axis. Then P sine alpha vertical downward. See, that's why the alpha came. So we have the mention, but here the see the statement, first statement, the minimum force P1 which will give the body, but when the point of sliding downwards, students, the body is sliding downwards. We applied force also horizontal, but the body is sliding downwards. The condition given, see the statement only. Generally, what you are taking friction force diagram, generally, the applied force, which direction? The opposite direction we are taking friction. But in the statement, even though we applied force horizontally, you see the statement. Have you seen the statement? We'll keep the body even into pointing, sliding down, sliding downwards. So body is moving downwards. That was friction. See, the friction is upward. Okay. So you have to draw the free body diagram. Okay. Same thing. How you can draw free body diagram? Let's say W cos alpha, W sin alpha. That is P cos alpha, P sin alpha. Additionally, P cos alpha, X direction. P sin alpha, Y direction. They have followed equilibrium equation, the final equation. They found the equation like this. Okay. P equal to P1 equal to W 10 alpha minus pi. For which condition? Yeah. Which condition this formula? The applied force horizontally, like this figure only. Students, for this figure, the final derived. Okay. P equal to W. 10 that is 10 alpha minus pi. Alpha means inclination, pi means angle of friction. Then the second, see the second condition. Now the body is sliding upwards. This diagram, see the case 2, sliding upward. See the condition. Even though P2 is acting horizontal, but the boy and the boy point of sliding is upwards. So after applying everything, the final equation P2 equal to W 10 alpha plus pi. P2 equal to, okay. So they see the pure problem. An object weigh 100 in the captain position plane in 30 degree to the horizontal force, applied force F. See the way we are taking horizontal force, what a P only we are taking, no? They mentioned F here. Don't take F, take P. Okay? The horizontal force P. Coefficient of friction on the surface increased to 0.25. Determine the minimum magnitude of force here, F. Okay, they asked the first condition. So, first condition formula is already there. First condition, F equal to, that is P equal to W. 10 alpha minus pi. Now see this one, our concept. Same everything they given. Find the inclination of plane. They asked alpha. Students, they asked alpha. Okay. So I will explain later the problems. Here I want to explain how the horizontal force converted into two component. We converted, no, P cos alpha, P sin alpha. Through paint, I explained, no? So today we discussed about, we really collected what we discussed, all the horizontal plane and inclined plane. Now this one, inclined plane, but the force is horizontal. Students, here the force is horizontal. So when force is horizontal, you have to convert xy direction. How do you convert xy direction? You, the angle alpha pi with respect to x-axis. I explained, okay? Same thing apply, equilibrium equation, everything, yeah, same. Summation of H0, summation of H0. Use these two equilibrium equation, find the unknown values. So with that, I want to conclude today's session. We will continue next class.